Hi people, welcome to this channel. I am Ehkam Ansari. I am back again with another very important and interesting video lecture. Students, let me tell you one thing. Information technology is not all about memorizing the fixed content or remembering the definitions. It's all about the learning new and dynamic things every day. Information technology is the only field where we use versions. Every time you see new and upgraded versions of different technologies. So students, if you want to deal with these technologies, you have to be the best version of yourself. In this particular video lecture, we will deal with some new features of input tag. In last lecture, we have seen some important attributes and values of input tag. So we will continue with the new and upgraded values and input tag and its values. So student, how to use these attributes and value we have already learned. First we have to start our notepad. And what is the notepad? We know notepad is our application platform where we run our coding, where we write our coding. So we will just move directly to our notepad program. So I will just type notepad. So you will get notepad easily on your computer and you can start your coding. So we have seen how to start our programming language or how to write our web application or web programming. So we have to write our coding, that is HTML coding or HTML5 coding in a web, in a application program, that is notepad, which is easily available in all Windows operating system. Okay, so we will just started our application, that is notepad, and we are going to start writing our code or programming, that is we are going to write our HTML5 coding, and we will learn how to use different input types and its attribute. We have already learned some important attribute of input tag, like we have seen input type equal to text in our previous video, then input type equal to number we have seen, input type equal to date we have seen, and we have already seen input type equal to email, where we can store email ID of a person, and we have seen input type equal to password, in which we store some password. Okay, in previous lecture we have already seen input type equal to URL, that is uniform resource locator. Okay, so in today's lecture we will see some more importance and very useful input types and its values, that is input type equal to radio. Okay, what is a radio? Radio is a button. For example, sometime we have to choose one value from n number of or from a group. For example, we have to select gender. So we have gender, three types of gender we have, that is male, female and others, or sometime it's called transgender. So we have three options. In that three options, we have to choose one value. Or you might be knowing that if you are going to attain any online exam, in that exam, we have to choose one option from A, B, C, D. So we get one button. That button is called as a radio button. Means from A, B, C, D, we have to choose only one option. Sometimes it's called as an option button. For example, if you select A, so it will be selected A, but when you click on B, the A will be deselected. Means at the time we can select only one from a group. This button is called as a group. This button is called as a radio button. Okay, then we will see in today's lecture, we will see range. What is range? Range, sometime we have to specify volume of any audio, video, or we can take any range. From the by default value of range is 0 to 100, and you can set as per your requirement. Okay, then next to input type we will see, that is input type equal to file. Okay, what is input type equal to file? Suppose you are going to send an email to your friend or to your family. In that email ID you write some content, some text, and at the same time you have to send your image or you have to send your resume or your biodata. So in that case you will get some something called you have to upload the file. So if you want to upload the file or image or any document, in that case you have to use input type equal to file. This input type equal to file will create a text box and a button. In that text box you have to select the location of your image or your biodata or your document, and when you click on that button you will open the place of your computer by where you can choose your file. So we will see one by one, that is input type equal to radio we will see, input type equal to range we will see, input type equal to file we will see. So we have to start our application, that is our notepad. As you know, if you are going to write HTML5, so first thing you have to write, that is not doc type. What is the doc type? That is HTML. Okay, after that you have to use regular expression of HTML, that is first tag, this HTML tag, and last tag will be HTML closing. Between these opening and closing HTML tag, you have to insert all other tags like head tag and closing head tag. Those who are new, I just want to tell you, these HTML tags are the building blocks of HTML language. Okay, for example, these are tags or these are elements. These are certain tools. HTML, that is hypertext markup language, it's a language. Okay, or you can say it's a tool. For example, if you take an example of a doctor, so what will be the tools of a doctor? The tools of doctor will be injections, medicines. Okay, all these are the tools of doctor. Without these tool, doctor cannot perform his work properly. In the same way, if you take an example of a teacher, the tools of teacher will be book, notebook, then chalk, then paper. These are some tools of teacher. So without these tool, teacher cannot perform their work properly. In the same way, HTML language is consist of different HTML tag. Without these tag, HTML language cannot perform their work properly. So if you want to use HTML tag, you have to learn the different uses and applications of HTML tags, or these tags also called as HTML element. So these are building blocks of HTML language. So the first tag of HTML tag is a HTML tag. Then we have to use the head tag. Then the very important tag, that is a body tag. Without body tag, HTML tag can HTML page cannot be completed. So body tag, all other tags will come inside these two body tag. Opening and closing body tag is a body of your page. Okay, so HTML, and on the top you can assign certain title to of the page. So you have to use title tag, then you have to use closing title tag. Okay, between that title you can write something. For example, we are going to learn today radio button, so you can write radio button. You can write okay. Now all other things come inside the body tag. First I am going to save. Those who are new, I just want to tell you, click on file, click on save. So first time it will ask where to save, means on your computer you can save anywhere, but for easy access I am going to save on desktop. On desktop, so my computer and desktop, so you have to assign certain name. So I am going to assign third, because this is the third lecture of advanced web designing, third.html. what is the third? Third is a name of file. Okay, what is third? Third is a name of file, and .html is an extension, because we are learning HTML. So all the extension will be .html and the name can be different. Okay, so click on save. Minimize the file and back to your desktop where you have saved the file. See, this is my file which I have just created. Double click. What is mean by double click? You are going to run your notepad file on your browser, because HTML runs on browser only. Now see, this is my first web application or web page which we have just created. Okay, but on the whole page we don't have any text or any images. Why? Because whatever you write inside the body tag, you will get on your browser. But right now I am getting one thing, that is radio button. This button or this line is written on title. So this bar is called as a title bar and this bar is called as a task bar. So on title, you will get title bar, that is radio button. I have written this line on title tag. Now I am going to minimize this and I am going to add something more. Means I am going to add some form and then I will see some input type. We have seen input type equal to, that is type, that is attribute of input tag. So I am going to add one more tag, that is H1 tag. What is the use of H1 tag? You know, that is the first heading, highest heading. Okay. So I am going to write use of form and input tag. Okay. So now just save the file. I am saving every time when I add one line, I am saying and I am showing your result. So don't be confused. I am going line by line. Just refresh the page. Now you will get use of form and input tag. This is coming because I am using H1 tag. Okay. Now I am going to add form tag. After that, I will add form tag. Then I am going to assign attribute, that is name equal to, you can assign any name. Okay. Then we have one more attribute, action equal to, then we have method equal to. So I can use, but right now I am going to use only input text. So first I am going to close form tag because all the input text will come inside these opening and closing tag, because input tag is a sub tag of a form tag. Like you may learn something called table tag in standard 11. So table tag consists of TR, TD. Okay, so these TR, TD are sub tag of table tag. In the same way, input tag is a sub tag of form tag. Okay, so in today's lecture we are about to learn three input type, that is radio and range and file. So we will start from radio, range and file. We will learn this thing, but before that I just want to add simple text box. For example, enter your name. Enter name. So in that I will take a simple text box, that is input type equal to text. Okay, then again I am going to add br. You know what is the use of br? That is, you are going to break new line. So again I am going to save. So you can learn from scratch. I am not going to type whole page then I am going to run. I will type line by line. I am showing you result line by line, so you can understand in a very good way. Okay, first I have added H1, so you will get this line. I am going to refresh. Now you will get enter name and this text box. Okay, so in that text box you can enter any name. Suppose Ansari Ahkam. Okay, you can write your name. Again I am back to my text box and I am going to add this type. What is the type? That is input type equal to radio. As I told you in the starting of this lecture, that input type equal to radio is used for a group, and in that group you can choose only one value. For example, I want to assign gender. Okay, gender. So what is the input type? I will take input type equal to, what is the input type? You have to take radio. Okay, so I just want to show you what is the result of this line. Don't be confused. Flip back to your browser. Okay, now refresh the page. Now this is the gender. I just want to increase the size, or I am going to zoom your page so you will get the clear picture of this page. Okay, this line is coming because of I have added H1, then this is I have just written hard-coded enter name, then this box is coming input type equal to text. This is hard-coded, that is I have written gender. Okay, and this is called as a radio button, where when you select it will be selected. Okay, or sometimes it's called as a option button, but in IT it's called as a radio button. Okay, now I have added one input, so it's showing one radio button. Again, if you add one more, for example, I'll just copy this content, Control C, and again Control V. Input type equal to radio, save it. I'm going to save. You can use Control S. I'm going to back to my browser, refresh the page. Now you will get two buttons, okay? Two radio button. One is from first input type is equal to radio, and this is from input type equal to radio. So before that, I will just add prefix the male and prefix the female. Okay. Or one more. So before the first radio button, that is gender, then this is the first radio button, I am going to add male. Okay, again I am going to save the file so you can get the clear picture of the browser. Okay, so here, see, before this radio button you will get one text, that is a male. Okay, so it's a male. Then before this I will add female. Again, flip back to your application file. So here I am going to add female. Again, see the output. Save file, flip back to browser. Again, I am going to refresh the page. So you will get female before this radio button. And before this radio button, I am going to add one more type of gender. That is, I think you are getting this point. Yes, yes or no, please tell me in comment, because radio button is a very important, and so very important in your career point of view, because many things to come in radio button only. That's why I have taken first. So before this input type equal to radio, I am going to add others, or you can say transgender, but the good word is others. Okay, so click on save, flip back to your browser, refresh the page. Now we will get a good form. In first we can enter our name, in second we can select our gender. Okay, in gender first we have male, second we have female, and third we have others. Okay, now when you click on me, for example, I have inserted my name Ansari Hakam. Okay, when I click male, so male is selected. Fine, it's a perfect working. But when you click on female, oh, even female is selected. And when you click on others, other is also selected. So logically it's incorrect. Am I correct? Logically it's incorrect, or it's illogical, because a person can not have more than one gender. So when I click on female, male will be disconnected, or when I click on others, means only one possible value can be stored. So to accept, to find or to execute this facility, we have to use one attribute of input tag, that is name. Okay, which attribute we have to use? Name. So just add one more attribute, that is name equal to, you can assign any name. For example, this is radio button, you can assign R1. You can take any name. Then in this radio button, again take one more name. Name equals to, you can assign R2. And in last radio button, again take name equals to R3. Okay, if you are not getting properly, I just want to align this thing. The first radio button, I'm going to, okay, I've just taken one line below, then for last. Okay, this is my first radio button. See, okay, I have just taken name attribute. Okay, this is my radio button. See, don't be confused, please don't be confused. This is radio button. It's a very interesting and it's a technically it's a very good for learning, because name attribute is very important. If you are going to assign or if you are going to select option button, okay, you have to take name. So name, I have selected R1 for the first radio button and name equal to R2. What is a name? Name is an attribute, like type is an attribute of input type. Okay, in the same way, name is an attribute of input tag. What is the R2? R2 is a value. You can assign any value to name attribute. In the same way, R3 is a value. As I told you, if you want to select one value from multiple values of radio button, you have to use name. So I have taken three different name. Okay, then I am going to save the file. Again, flip back to my browser, refresh the page, choose any name, for example ABC. Then I am going to select the gender. When I click on male, it's selected. When I click on female, oh no, what's happening? Means I have used name attribute, it's still I did not get my result. Means the all three option buttons are selected, which is not possible. Am I correct? Yes. I have intentionally given different name so you can get clear picture of the radio button. If you are going to create a group of radio button in which we are going to select a single button or single value, in that case you have to assign similar name to all the radio buttons. Okay, so you have to assign same name to all the radio button. For the name equal to R1, instead of R1 you have to take all same name. You can take R1, so you have to assign second radio button R1 and same R1 to your third radio button. Okay, so the name will be same. This is the very important point. Okay, this is very important point of radio button. If you are going to create group of radio button, in that group you are going to select only one option, in that case we have to use name attribute, and in name attribute we have to assign same value to all the radio button. So I have taken R1. You can take anything. For example, just save the file, flip back to your browser and refresh the page. Now enter any name, ABC, select male is selected, very good. Select female. When you click on female, see the male button is deselected, and when you click on others, see the female button is deselected. This is what we are going to write or what we actually want. Okay, so we get our result, we get our output. So how we come this result? We have given similar name to all the radio button. We have given name equal to R1. You can take any name. For example, you can assign A. You can assign A. You can assign A. But the important thing is, what is the logic behind this? You have to write the same name. Okay. So you have to save this file and flip back to your browser. Refresh the page. Now you can insert certain name. You have to click on male, then female, then others. Okay, so you have to click only once. When you click on male will be selected, but when you click on female will be selected and male will be deselected. This is what we want. Okay, I think you get this, how to write radio button. Now if you have any query related to radio button, then don't be confused. We have many attributes with the radio button, which is about to come in next lecture. But the thing is, today in this lecture we are going to just learning our basic input tag and its attribute. With the time we will learn some new and extra features of input type and attribute, but for the time being we are going to learn one more attribute, that is input type equal to range. Suppose you want to set certain volume to your audio or video, so in that case we will take range. For example, age between. Okay, so what is the input type? I will take input type equal to, what is the input type? That is range. Okay, by default value is 0 to 100. Okay, input type equal to range. When you take, I'm just going to add one BR. What is the use of BR? You know, that is, it will break the line. Save the file. Okay, flip back to your browser. See, refresh the page. You will get edge between. So this is starting from 0 to 100. Okay, you can scroll to any value. Okay, the default value is 0 to 100. Okay, you can set at any value. Now it's mostly using when you are going to set certain volume of any audio video, or sometimes it's also used for age or any number we have, in which we have to assign some upper value and lower value. Okay, then the last topic of today's lecture is we have to learn how to upload a file. Okay, first we have seen input type equal to radio, in which we seen how to select from multiple options by using name attribute. Then we have to assign the same name to name attribute. Then we have seen input type equal to range, where we can set different range starting from 0 to 100. This is a default value of range attribute, and we can assign any value. Then today's topic, that is input type. The last topic of today's lecture is a input type equal to file. And what is the use of input type equal to file? Suppose you want to upload your resume or your bio data or your image. In that case, you have to use input type equal to file. Okay, it's a very important when you are going to create any web application. In that case, you have to upload certain image or file. So this attribute, this feature of HTML5 is very good, and how to use this we will see in this application. So I'm just going to add one more BR, that is new line, and I'm going to add upload file. Upload file, you can write, or you can write anything. Okay, what is the input type? Input type equals to, you have to write file. Okay, then BR, just save the file, flip back to your browser, refresh the page. Okay, now see, you have uploaded file. When you click choose file, okay, this is the by default button. When you click on that, see, I'm going to click, so it will search from your computer. So you can search from any, you can upload anything. For example, I am going to upload code.txt, that is any file you can upload. When you click on open, so code.txt file is uploaded. Okay, again I'm going to refresh. See, right now what we are getting, no file chosen. So choose file, so you can choose any file, first page.html. Okay, I click open. Now the first.html file means input type equal to file means you can upload any file. The file type is not important. You can upload HTML file, image file, text file, PPT, or any type of file you can upload. But the important thing is you can upload any file. So input type equal to file means you can upload any file, in which you will get one button. When you click on that button, it will show your computer's location. From that location, you can select any file. So when you click on select or upload file, it will show which file is uploaded. So right now we have uploaded firstpage.html file. Okay. Yes. Any question? If you have any question, please post below in comment section. Inshallah, I will reply with suitable answer. Okay, now I think we have completed our today's topic. Now I'm just going to add one more thing, that is input type equals to button, or you can take submit. I think because this button, the form is looking incomplete. Okay, input type equal to submit, value equals to save. What is the use of value attribute? You know, it will show the label of your button. Save the file, and I am going to show the result. Okay, so now you will get one more button which is added by using input type equal to submit. So when you write anything from this content and when you click on male, female, whatever your gender, and select your age, whatever, it's starting from 0 and end from 100, and it's by default on middle, that is 50. And you can choose any file, that is your image or your biodata. You can add any file. Okay, for example, armstrong number.html. So when you click save, it will save on the server. Okay, where it will save? It will save on certain location which we have already specified. Right now I have not specified, so you can specify on action. That is, we have discussed action. What is the action attribute of form tag? Action equal to kms.php. actually, action, or you have to create this file on server, so it, the data of this form will be transfer. What is the data? The data means the name which you have entered inside input tag, and the gender which you have selected, and the age which you have selected. Then your file, these are the data of this form. When you click on submit button, the data will be transferred to kms.php page. Okay, and that is a server page. Okay, so save this, click back to your browser, run this file. Interestingly, for example, you have entered ABC gender, you have taken age, you have chosen any file, for example codex, open. When you click on save, see the browser, kms.php is showing. Okay, kms.php. okay, right now we have not created kms.php, that's why it's showing only the URL of php, kms.php. So we have completed what today's topic. I just want to recap this video lecture, okay, which we have started. Okay, first we have started with the input tag, and in input tag we have seen radio button. In radio button, the important thing was we have to take the name attribute and we have to assign same name to all the radio button. Then we have seen range attribute of input type. What is the range attribute? This is the attribute which is used to assign certain range starting from 0 to 100. This is the by default value given by the HTML5. Then we have seen input type equal to file. What is the use of file? We have to upload, it gives facility to upload any file, any type of file. The type is not important, you can upload, in which you will get one button. When you click on that button, it shows the computer location. Okay, so you can select any file and then you can upload the file. I hope you will understand this video. If you don't understand, or if you have any query related to this video, please share your comment. Inshallah, I will reply with the suitable answer. Thank you very much. Keep learning, stay tuned with this channel. Many things to come. Allah Hafiz.